aking palaban at walang inuurungan.
Gusto mo mawala na lahat ng saysayang pagpunta mo dito?
Fierce and fabulous pagdating sa aktingan.
Oh yes, I know everything!
She has the guts to be a lady boss and a cool mom. She is Rufa Gutierrez, isang certified showbiz royalty. We saw her beauty and talent, pero sa likod ng glitz and glamour, isang matapang at palaban na babae at ina. With her powerful love and strength as a woman, she has raised two beautiful daughters, Laurid and Venice. Tunay siyang inspirasyon sa maraming kababaihan. Ngayon tara na at makipagkamustahan with Rufa Gutierrez, only here on I Feel You.
And you are back with us here on I Feel You at kasama natin ngayon ang isa sa mga tinututukang character tuwing hapon sa Love Thy Woman, a certified showbiz royalty, the one and only Miss Rufa Gutierrez. Hi, Miss Rufa!
Hello, Tony! Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. And I'm so happy to see you. Polka dots means money, so yes. We will be blessed today.
Yes. Positivity, lahat. Ayan, i-attract natin yan. Well, first of all, we would like to congratulate you sa success ng inyong serya na Love Thy Woman. Congratulations!
Nakakabili. Yes, maraming salamat. Kasi number one kami, Tony, sa lahat ng online streaming sa Kapamilya Channel, talagang tinututukan kami, not only here, but abroad. So, sa lahat ng tumututok at tumatawag sa akin ng Amanda Del Mundo, maraming salamat.
Yes, nakakabilib dahil syempre, you were doing the serie, wala pa yung pandemic hanggang sa nagkaroon ng pandemic and then nagkaroon ng issue with the franchise and all. But you were all able to survive and adjust and go back on air with an exciting show, di ba? So, paano nyo na-survive yung challenges ng tapings, ng new normal? Paano yung naging sistema sa set?
Actually, every time I look back, bilib na bilib ako talaga sa amin, sa sarili namin, sa buong cast, crew, staff, kasi napakahirap gumawa ng isang production. Napakahirap i-maintain yung excitement, you know, with everything that was going around, especially we were shooting the day na nag-shutdown. So can you imagine, may eksena kami na dapat hindi iyakan. Biglang lahat kami umiiyak sa set. Sabi ko, Direk, pwede na bang kunan yung mga iyakan scenes natin? Kasi pinataya na tayo, nag-no na yung Congress. Sabi ko, gawin na natin yung mga mabibigat na eksena. Kasi kahit na hindi kami kailangan maging emotional, lahat kami talaga were so emotional. But I also must say, Tony, talagang bilib na bilib din ako sa ABS-CBN. Kasi in spite of everything that's happened, in spite of all of the challenges that they've gone through, pilit nila talagang mag-survive. And they're doing it. They're really successful. Kasi hanggang ngayon, sinundan kami sa digital, di ba? Sinasabi nila na, ako, pag walang free TV, wala na. Hindi ako naniniwala doon kasi I believe that digital is the future. We just have to adapt to it and we just have to embrace it, you know? Hindi naman lahat nasa digital pa rin, pero eventually lahat tututok na sa atin.
Yeah, because you embrace that. Tingnan nyo naman kung paano kayo in-embrace ng inyong mga loyal viewers dahil number one, hindi ba, sa digital streaming. So, how are you thankful sa inyong mga viewers na sinundan kayo from free TV to digital? Gaano kayo ka-thankful and grateful sa kanila?
I'm very thankful. I'm very grateful. Not only because I have work, dahil maraming walang trabaho ngayon. I'm also grateful sa lahat ng mga nanonood at sumusubaybay sa amin araw-araw. Kung pwede ko lang silang sulatan isa-isa. Hello to everyone who's watching. At Tony, hindi lang sa Pilipinas, talagang all over the world. Talagang, hi, I'm from Bahrain. Hi, I'm from Seattle. Hi, I'm from Saudi Arabia. Girl, pag nag-international star na ako, baka sumikat na ako. Kasi tayong mga Pilipino, grabe magmahal. Diba? Talagang hanggang Bahrain nanonood sila.
Diba?
And that, I think that is really the strength also of ABS-CBN. Talagang worldwide in the service of the Filipino.
Yes, connecting our kapamilyas from different parts of the world. Pero syempre dito sa teleserye nyo, lahat kayo strong women. Tamang-tama, dahil kasi ang usapan natin ngayon, Miss Rufa, I love na mga kababaihan. Gaano nga ba ka-powerful ang pagmamahal ng isang babae? Di ba sinasabi nila yan, behind every man's success is a woman. Diba?
Well, sa tingin ko talaga ang babae nagdadala ng relasyon. Kasi like what you said, di ba, kung walang successful man, I mean, if there's a successful man, behind that is a successful woman, you know, and it's how you take care of your man. And I believe yung pagmamahal ng isang babae sa lalaking worth it and deserving of our love, eh talagang pwede sila. Kasi inaalagaan natin sila, and we do everything to make them feel loved.
Ikaw naman, Miss Rufa, when it comes to romantic love, kasi as a woman, you really have a strong personality. Is it difficult for you to fall in love?
In the past, no. I always fall in love. But I think as you get older, you become wiser, you become more picky. And I think for me, I'd rather be alone than with a man that's very destructive, di ba? Parang for me, okay naman ako mag-isa eh. Kaya ko naman mabuhay with my kids, with my dogs, with my career, with my life. Because buo ako sa sarili ko, I'm happy on my own. So I don't need a man to just complete me, you know? I mean, I need a man that will grow with me. I need a man that will make me feel happy. And if he doesn't fulfill that need anymore, okay, bye. Kaya nga, ayoko nga magpakasal ulit eh. Kasi, di ba, you have to go through an annulment again. Tapos marami ako nakikita mga marriages na parang they're just with their partners because, you know, for the kids, just to make it work. Parang for me, life is short, di ba? If you're not in love with your partner and things are really destructive, bye!
Bye! So, paano na bago bye. Na experience mo yung in relationships, yung pananaw mo sa pag-ibig?
Well, sa tingin ko, nagbago talaga kasi, you know, I'm very different, I guess, when it comes to my perception of love. A lot of my Bible study mates are always saying, Rufa, you know, you have to get married again. We really pray for you. Na you'll have a family again. And I'm like, guys, I'm okay. You don't need to pray for me. I'm not lonely. I'm fine the way I am. And I think with love, to each his own, diba? I mean, we like younger guys. We like older guys. We like being married, you know. So I think there's no such thing as traditional love anymore. It's up to you, you know. That's why they say love is love, diba? Pwede na rin, you know, whatever it is that you feel in your heart, that's what should be accepted.
So right now, your preference is anything. You're open for anything, or you're not open to love, or you're in love.
No, I mean, ako. I mean, if it happens, it happens, diba? I mean, if Doc Vicky Tony got married in her 60s and it was a big celebration, why not? You know, it doesn't mean that we're over 40. Kailangan mahiya na tayo. No, you know, it depends on my story. Hindi ko dapat ikahiya yung story ako because I was a battered wife. So, I didn't want to stay in that relationship anymore, diba? So, if the time comes that my partner will propose, or and I feel that it's right, and I feel that it'll make me happy forever, girl, kahit 70, pwede ako magpakasal. Why not?
At 70, she got married.
Diba? Oh, diba?